Science fiction tends to envision the universe as similar to our personal experiences. Aliens look an awful lot like humans, planets look like snapshots of Earth, and stars resemble our sun. In truth, the universe has the possibility to contain just about anything, and we're learning a whole lot of it is actually staggeringly different from what we might expect. These are the 10 strangest things found in space. No known event in the universe puts out as much energy as a gamma ray burst. Lasting between a few milliseconds and several hours, gamma ray bursts are hundreds of times brighter than supernovas and trillions of times brighter than the sun. In fact, if we converted all the sun's mass to energy, it wouldn't be as powerful as a single gamma ray burst. Many bursts are thought to be the product of the collapse of very dense, quickly rotating stars. A powerful jet of gamma rays can be ejected as a star transforms into a neutron star, magnetar, or black hole. If current theories are right, over 80% of the matter in the universe is dark matter. We can't visibly see it. It does not radiate measurable energy. It doesn't absorb radiation, blocking the emissions of other celestial bodies. So, why do we think it even exists? Because the universe as a whole operates as if there is far, far more mass in it than we can detect. We see the influence of dark matter through the effects of gravity, which is entirely dependent on mass. Planet 55 Cancri E, also known as Janssen, is about twice as big as Earth, but 8 times as massive, and it's comprised primarily of carbon. Not just any carbon, however. Heat and pressure have transformed a third of the planet into diamond. 55 Cancri E was the first rocky planet to be discovered with a radically different chemical makeup than Earth. In our own solar system, the rocky planets are made primarily of silicon-oxygen compounds. Sagittarius B2 is a 150 light-years wide molecular cloud inside the Milky Way. Included in those molecules are high quantities of alcohol. The center of the cloud is a comfortable 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Also present is ethyl formate. That's interesting to scientists because it's a major precursor to amino acids, which are necessary for life as we know it. The rest of us can find it interesting because it naturally smells of rum and is partly responsible for the flavor of raspberries. If there's a natural party center of the universe, this might be it. SID 42 sits 4 billion light years away. At some point in its history, it collided with another galaxy and the two fused. The black holes at the center of those galaxies also fused, forming a single supermassive black hole. The weird part, however, is what happened next. The gravity waves from the collision ejected that black hole into space at the speed of several million miles an hour. The fact that this could happen to an object millions of times more massive than the sun is a little mind-boggling and may get you to better appreciate the raw power of the universe. If a diamond planet isn't cool enough for you, the universe appears to have one-upped itself and made a diamond star. It's a white star, the remnants of a sun-sized star now compressed into the size of Earth. It's extremely cold, too cold for us to detect directly. Granted, that could still be as much as 3,000 degrees Kelvin or 5,000 degrees Fahrenheit, but that's dead cold for a star. The only way this unnamed star could be so cold and not be older than the Milky Way in which it resides is for its carbon to have compressed into diamond. Because they're so hard to detect, it's entirely possible that many other diamond white dwarfs exist. We only found this one because it exists in a binary system with an observable pulsar and the very catchy name of PSR J2220137. 12 billion light years away is the largest known reservoir of water vapor in the universe, about 140 trillion times more water than can be found on Earth. This reservoir orbits around a black hole, which is slowly capturing most of this water mass. Besides being the largest collection of water in the universe, it's also the oldest, having existed for a couple of billion years after the Big Bang. Most of the universe, even parts that appear completely empty, emit cosmic microwave background radiation. But there is an area in the Eridanus constellation, some 500 million to 1 billion light years across, that is a CMB cold spot. For some reason, this gigantic area of space isn't radiating nearly as much radiation as the rest of the universe. It's suspected that this region of the universe is a supervoid, a patch of space unusually devoid of matter, including the pesky, undetectable dark matter. But that just pushes the question back a step. Why is that area of our universe so desolate? You'd think separating planets from stars would be easy, right? Not really. Brown stars are thought to form similarly to stars, but never reach the mass necessary to fuse hydrogen into helium. Most of the energy they throw off is infrared, rather than visible light, a very low energy form of radiation. And they can get cold. The smallest subclass of brown dwarfs is the Y dwarfs, and the coldest of those is only about 80 degrees Fahrenheit. In many ways, brown dwarfs are similar to gas giant planets. They're about the size of Jupiter, but are more massive. And gas giants, including those in our own solar system, emit their own radiation as well. Galaxy 3C303 is ejecting what appears to be an electric current from its center. The current is a trillion times greater than a lightning bolt on Earth, and it extends some 150,000 light years. Scientists theorize that the magnetic fields of a black hole in the center of the galaxy are generating the current. Super dense structures are already thought to eject jets of different types of energy. Black holes do it in the form of quasars, while neutron stars do it as pulsars. However, they throw the energy off as radiation. Instead, 3C303 throws off electricity. For more top lists just like this, be sure to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already, and don't forget to check out our other lists, and we'll see you all next time.